Hello guys, welcome back to our channel, The Amazing Pocket 10. Today, let's make a ball attack game in Scratch. I named this project, so the first thing we need to do is to get rid of this cat. Pick a sprite. I'll choose Giga. And I'll choose a ball, which is the beach ball. Yes. I'll just decrease the size to 75. Yeah, because it's too big. I'll choose the background, which is blue sky. Yeah. Now first, let's start with Giga. So when green flag clicked, it should go to X0. And then here, yes. Now, what we want Giga to do is that it should follow our mouse pointer. So it will follow our mouse pointer and go wherever we go horizontally, that's in the x coordinate. So for that, I'll say set x2 and go to forever loop, keep this here, go to sensing and grab mouse x. So what this will do is that it will set x of Giga to our mouse x wherever the mouse pointer is. Yeah, so I'll keep this here. Next, it is working. Okay, now we should go with the peach ball. So we'll start the code with when green flag clicked. Okay, then it should do set y to minute top here. Yeah. Yes, set y to 188 and set x to, it should pick random. So for that, I'll go and take a block here that is named as pick random in operators. I will choose from there, that is minus 199 to 200. Yeah. Yes. Now, yeah, it's working. It's picking random. See, it's picking. So now go to forever in control forever loop. Now go to motion, change y by minus y. Now we are telling it to pick random on the top and then come down to Giga like this. Okay, that's done. That part is done. Good. Now the problem here is that if it's touching this edge, then it should go back again. So for that, I'll go to if then touching edge, what I'll do is duplicate this and keep it here. From 200 to, let's say, minus 197 to 197. Or okay, or let's say 190 to 190. Oh, yeah, it's not working. So because since we put the coordinates which are touching the edge on the top, it'll just be on going random on that place. So for that, and also the y position is here. So for that, I'll take another block which is touching color. I'll grab this out and then say touching color. I'll take it from here. Yes. Now if it's touching it, yes, it's going again to the top. Fine, this is working good. Now let's start it again. Now the game is here is that Giga should escape from this ball attack, so it will be safe. Now, I'll duplicate this. If then touching Giga, I'll go here. Alright. Giga walking. Then, it should actually, you know, we will create a variable called lives for all sprites. Yes. So, we will change the lives by minus 1, and we'll rename this variable as score, and we will change score by 1 if it's touching the ground. So when we start the game, life should be set to 5 because it will have the minimum, and score should be set to 0. So now let's try that. Yes, it's working. Now if there are 0 lives and then it's not stopping again, what it's doing, it's continuing the game. So I'll duplicate this. I'll go to operators and I'll pick this equals to block, go to variables, take lives, and if it's equals to 0, then it will broadcast a message. Or I'll do one thing, I'll keep it in the background and I'll take this off from here. So forever if then here the number of lives equals to 0, so what it should do, it should switch the backdrop to game over. So let's see, I use this one, game over, click the green light to play again. I'll centralize it and I will change the font to curly. I'll change the font color to complete red. Yes, then it should switch backdrop to not blue sky, backdrop. Oh, wait. I'll name that backdrop as game over. Okay, yes, good. Now, when the game started, it should be in blue sky, so I'll keep that there. 1, 2. 3 gone, 4 gone, and then but the game is still continuing. So for that I'll go to control and then click stop all, then I will go to layer. I will drop this message here in Giga and then I'll take out both of these and then it should hide if number of lives equals to 0. Same with the beach ball, I'll put it here, I'll put this here. 5, 3, 2, 1. Yes, it's good. Now I'm gonna create a new sprite called lives. So since there are 5 lives, I'm gonna add, I list select Giga, copy and then paste it. I'll just change the size to very small. Okay, no, I'll just, yeah, I'll copy this, paste it again, copy this, paste it again, 3, paste, 4, paste, 5, yes. So now let's go this, when clicked show, I forgot to add, show when the game starts for both of them. Okay, now for this, so I'm gonna duplicate this one and then remove one, duplicate it, remove one, duplicate it, remove one, duplicate it, remove one, and then duplicate this and remove this and then say wait, let's remove that all. Yeah, no, yes, that's the last one. So I'll code here. I'll go to backdrop and then take this here. Just sprite one. Okay. I name this life of Giga. If the number of lives equals to 4, then it switch costume to, I name them lives 1. I'll copy that costume 4 command, lives 4, lives 3, lives is 4, oh sorry, this is 2, this is 4, this is 1. Yes, perfect. So yeah, first it should switch a costume to life full, then if the number of lives equals to 4, then switch to lives 4, number of lives equals to life 3, then switch costume to life 3, not this, I duplicate this, number of lives equals to life 2, switch costume to life 2, number of lives equals to 1, switch costume to lives 1. Yeah. Okay. And then should be on the top right side here. I'll also show the variable score. Okay. I'll just put them like this. I'll not show the variable life because it's written here. And then here, I'll show that. Now I'll click this. It's, wait. Why did that happen? Huh? Number of lives equals to 4, switch life to 4. Number of lives equals 3, switch life to 3. Number of lives equals 2, switch life to 2. Number of lives 1. Life to 1. So when clicked, it should switch its life to full life. So what I'll do is not this much. Number of lives equals to 5 full life. Okay. I'll keep that here. Well, 4 means it did 2, so now let's say wait until number of lives equals to equals to 3. No, it's not working. So I just click hide the number of lives equals to 0. So when lives equals to 5 full, when lives equals to 4, it is switch life costume to one, two, three. Did not tell it to show. See, it's doing the exact opposite. So I'll try that again. Once it's 4, it's switching to 2. So Now this is yes, here is a mistake. Lives 2, lives 4. This is life 4. When number of life equals to life 4, which costume to life 4? Life 2 is yes. Now let's try that. 4. Yes, that's it. Number of lives equals 0, it should have. Okay, I'll just take out this lives thingy. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Cut them. It's done. Yes. Okay, it's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, game over. Okay, now I'm going to grab this forever when green flag clicked. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, when life equals 2. Let's see. No. Okay, that's over. Good. So that's it, guys. Today's game. So the boss will continuously attack. Now, like, I'm gonna add. I'll just duplicate the speech ball so that there'll be extra fun in this game. But what I'll do is I'll just add 1 second. So that it would be even more challenging and harder to play. So yes, I'll hide it when it starts. I'll duplicate this baseball and then I'll click 2. So there are total 3 balls, guys. So it'll be become more challenging and fun. See, if we just hit the ball or touch it, the lives change. So thank you guys for watching my videos. Meet you in the next video. And then like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and share this video with your friends and family. So thank you for watching. Bye.